noble swordsman! Battle! We hunger for blood and battle! Elite Lancers! You want some fancy rip-roaring, rousing speech, do you now? Well, I can honestly say you are the ugliest, hardest, most degenerate bastard sons of bitches I've ever seen! That's it! Now, let's go to work. Elite Lancers! Riders, advance!
Our ally is attacked! Should we aid them?
Move it! Get running! Move!
Men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
Come, Cassian! As you say! Elite Lancers! Gotcha! Raiders, advance! Ready for battle! Battle one!
Enemy general is fallen!
It's running! Forward! Warriors, move out!
Aye!
Warriors, move out!
Melee fighters ready!
What curse you!
Get running! Battle ready and eager!
Move it!
Battle ready! allies' general has fallen.
Get running! Move it! We will pierce their hearts.
A unit has fired all of its ammunition.
Deadly missiles ready!
Ready for battle! Move it! Warriors eager for blood! Battle ready and eager! Get running!
Our spears are yours!
Warriors move out!
Battle ready and eager!
Ready for battle? Get running!
Fearless warriors!
Run, curse you! Noble swordsmen! Spearmen! Move it! Get running!
Warriors, move out!
Yeah!
Axes!
Up and are running for their lives.
Noble soldiers, get running!
As you say!
Move it!
Wooden!
Warriors, move out!
We'll kill them all!
Shield wall now!
Move it! Speed! Withdraw!
Men return to the fight!
What curse you?
Echo!
Hurt! Miners! Far riders! Mountain death! Quickly now!
We hunger for blood and battle!
Kill them all! Run, curse you! Gotcha! Charge!
Aventores! Armored Legio!
Attacking our general! The general has fallen! Our victory grows ever nearer! More ammunition! This ship will continue firing! One of our ships is out of ammunition!
Orders understood! Move out! By your command! Glory of God! Quick, march!
General!
Yes, Commander!
Ammunition stocks restored! The ship has replenished its ammunition. Men are running! Stand and fight, damn you! The ship has depleted its ammo reserves. More ammunition! This ship will continue firing! The tower is nothing but ash now.
Melee horsemen! Señores!
Your orders.
Defend! Quick march! Bastards! I will cut out your hearts! Flank them! Enemy approaching, sir!
Strike low!
Strike low! Into the enemies!
Thank you.
The men have thrown down their weapons and are fleeing!
Courage, men! Stand by!
Lewted! Find the plans at speed! Engage!
Victory is imminent!
I thought I was done streaming, didn't you? Turns out I wasn't. I thought I was gonna do one stream today, do Chronicle, that's it. Then I decided to continue with Attila because I still have a bunch of stuff to talk about it. Let's talk about in Attila. Yeah, sorry. Like, for example, my upcoming guide where I still have to do the desert factions. I haven't really mastered Himyar, so I have to do that. Athar's Chosen are, of course, one of the units that you want to master. This campaign, I almost have a military victory for, so that's good. And then the Western Roman Empire when I have to defeat the Huns, which is another problem.
Carrion birds and jackals will grow fat on your carcasses and lose the taste for your rancid flesh.
Good win, thanks. I think the last time I played this campaign, I saw that I just decided to save it and then go to a different campaign because I thought I wasn't going to be able to win it and then I'd have to retake that territory or it would get sacked, and I didn't want to deal with that, but I just decided to do it on stream, see if I could do it, and I was able to do it. A reminder that this is a hard campaign, and of course the Eastern Roman Empire has an initial difficulty of very hard, but they can become really easy later on. To survive until 450, so that's about 40 more turns. I have everything, Armenia and Azerbaijan I can take within a few turns, but I'm gonna wait. Everything else I have except 90 settlements, of course, and those two provinces. So now it's just more of a waiting game. And of course, I have to take a few territories in Spain. Basically, if you're not familiar with my campaign, I am the strongest faction right now. I defeated the Huns before I got on my minor victory, which was really cool. I had to deal with Hispania, who had all of Spain and a few territories in Africa. Like, they had 13 territories. They've gone down to 4. The Ebdanians were helping them, and they had about 9, and then now they're a horde. We weren't at war with the Alemans. We actually had them as our puppet states, but then they broke off, and then we made peace with them, and now we're at war with them again. And yeah, a lot of factions do not like us, but that's fine because we are probably going to win anyway.
Speak words of strength. Reply then,
with a strength that welcomes peace.
My words were heard.
I have not done a Celtic campaign yet. Oh, you know what I just realized? I made a mistake. I was supposed to send an army over there to fight the Alamans. Oh boy. Yeah, I was supposed to send an army over here. I guess it's too late for that. I still think the Western Roman Empire is better than the Eastern Roman Empire. Just in gameplay wise and, you know, with their strategies. But who knows? I'm actually not going to continue this campaign on stream. I'm going to finish it off stream. Probably not today, but tomorrow. Just because I wanted to talk about the guide and give you guys an update. Or if you don't know that I'm doing a guide, well, I'm doing one for Attila. I did one for Rome 2, and a lot of, or not a lot of people, but over 500 people looked at it, and I thought that it would be a good idea to do one for Attila, even though Attila's base game is practically broken right now, thanks to the Slavs, and as well as the overpowered shock cavalry. Still, Attila's pretty fun. Like, Rome 2 isn't broken, but Rome 2 does have a lot of faults. Still, Rome 2 gets played more than Attila does, which is pretty interesting. The bejeweled retinue. It's been a while since I've played as the Alamans, and I haven't even done their campaign yet. I just realized I have to do that too. I did the Franks, I've done the Langobards, but I haven't done the Burgundians or Alamans or the Saxons. So that's on my to-do list, of course.
Today, because that is the task the Lord has given us. It is a noble task. We will make him proud that his people have such sons as us.
So yeah, basically, the Eastern Roman Empire is one of the more interesting factions in this game, in my opinion. Well, both Roman factions are interesting because they're not like the Romans in Rome 2. They're much, much weaker.
there is nothing but ash now.
Armored Legio! And the double! Ready and waiting!
On your command!
Armored Legio! We await your command! Quick march!
By the mercy of the good Lord!
Melee infantry ready!
Hold on tight, lads!
Oh, I'm the fan!
Armored Legio! Melee horsemen! Orders understood!
General is under attack! Victory grows ever nearer!
Armored Legio! Quick march! Yes, Commander! Armored Secretariat! Hold! Advance the speed! For glory!
Thank you.
just a little tip for you guys. If you play Attila, don't play as the Guild Mansions in multiplayer. Not even in campaign. It's not worth it. It just isn't. I've been stuck with them for like the longest time now because of the Fraction of Faith, debuff that the culture itself has. And then the fact that they have a weak roster just makes life so much worse. They're not worth it, in my opinion, to play as. Not even the Shawia Guard. Like, they have the same shield as the Immortals, but they're pretty bad. And their skins aren't Garamantian either.
We do not give gifts lightly, and never to common folk.
Hmm.
I have been...
Not just yet. We still have more territories to take from them. I have to take back Narbo from these guys because I don't need the territory itself, but I do need to get, I do need 90 settlements just to feel safe. But I will save that for tomorrow if I do decide to stream. Now for some things that will be on my Total War guide. I'm going to make a reference to another guide that was made, and I just found it actually. It was made on Steam. And I will put it in the chat. Walrus Jones is somebody that knows the database better than I do. So just give him a look if you really want to get into the game. Attila, Rome 2, doesn't matter. Okay, so, sorry about that. Basically, one of the things that will, or some of the things that will be on my guide is the unit spotlight. I will be going over every faction, for sure, like I did with Rome 2. However, some factions do have specific units that I will be talking about. For example, the Huns, I'll be talking about their Ur warriors. With the Axum, I'll be talking about the Spice Guard. With, the Slavs, it will just be poison arrows and so on. I'll also be talking about some of the mechanics, some of which is actually mentioned in the guide that I just posted in the chat. And I'll also be talking about like their in-game effectiveness and their campaign effectiveness. Some of these factions I did complete the campaign with. Still have a bunch to do, but as you can see, I'm just going for a military victory with the Eastern Roman Empire right now. I did the Huns, minor victory and military victory. I got a minor victory with the Western Roman Empire and the White Huns, but there's a bunch that I haven't done. I'll also be talking about my favorite faction, which is the Franks. And I made a lengthy post about them. Like, what I think they're good at, what I think they are pretty bad at, where their in-game effectiveness is, campaign effectiveness, and so on. And of course, if you didn't know, single-handed axes do have a bonus to attack against infantry of 10. I don't know if they have a bonus to, like, weapon damage as well, but I doubt it because of how this game works and how cavalry work. Cavalry, for example, do have a bonus of 5 against infantry, and that's not just to attack, it's also to weapon damage. And it hasn't been stated, like, otherwise. That affects all cavalry. It's been in the game since Shogun 2, like the 5 bonus versus cav. In Napoleon, it was higher, it was 25. or something. And also, of course, the weapons that have a bonus to attack against infantry. For example, a club, like the Langobards have, if I can find them, here or there. The club has a bonus, this club has a bonus to 10 against infantry. Bonus to attack against infantry of 10. So their attack against infantry goes up to 37. And these skilled clubmen have the bonus, the heavier one. So their attack goes up to 50. They get a bonus to attack of 20 versus infantry. Their weapon damage, as far as I'm concerned, stays the same, but these guys are very tanky and very good at taking on multiple mid-tier melee units. As long as they're not like cavalry, they should be fine. And then of course there is the Spatha, not the Spatha, the Conda, that I'll be talking about in detail. And yeah, like, hopefully I'll be able to release it later this month. I planned to. I just have to go over the desert factions, the Celts, and the Slavs, and that's it. Oh yeah, and I also have to, I wanted to do, like, a campaign overview for each faction, but I'll probably implement that later after I publish it. But if you guys want to know anything else, like any of my knowledge in Attila, Rome 2, or any Total War game that I own Empire 2, Attila, I don't have Warhammer, you know, you can always ask. You can ask on stream, you can ask now, I don't mind. I also wanted to talk about two more things. Like I said, the Gower Mansions are pretty useless. You know, if you wanted to, like, at least win, chances are you shouldn't use this faction. They're not the best. Like, they do have access to better camels than, like, the other factions, technically. But this doesn't serve them well. Their best shock cav unit is actually a lower tier than their second best. But they do have a better charge bonus. So you have to make up your mind there. And they also have more armor too. Oh yeah, that reminds me. I also have a theory about armor and how base and shield value work. See, in Age of Charlemagne, it's different because all the armor is put into base, and I was saying, you know, that should have been implemented since Rome 2 because it's really useless. But in Rome 2 and Attila, armor is split into base value, which is the body armor, and shield value, which is, of course, your shield armor. Shield armor is basically useless against missiles. Shields are useful for blocking missiles, but if you get hit in the rear by missiles, then there's no missile block chance, obviously. And, of course, missile block chance varies from unit to unit. For example, this Lancer unit has a missile block chance of 20, which means that they do have shields. So they can block missiles, but not that many. In melee, however, all of the armor is considered, as far as I'm concerned. It's another one of my theories I cannot confirm yet, but it, like, I'm still looking into the files just to see if it will tell you anything more. Skirmisher cavalry don't get a lot of love in the base game, but they are useful. And I may talk about the Noble Numidian Cavalry because they're a pretty good unit, like, cost-wise, even though they're pretty expensive. And, yeah, but overall, the Gower Mansions are not worth it. The Burgundians, if you were watching my stream when I just started, was the faction I was playing as. Basically, the Burgundians are, you know, they're a barbarian kingdom. The only special units they have are in the Slinger and Skirmishing departments. They do have Royal Lancers, which are very, very good on the charge. And they cost 725 talents. I think they also wield the Barbed Lance, so yeah, that's pretty good in their part. The Barbed Lance does not grant any bonuses to, like, infantry or cavalry, but, like, I think they should, even though I don't like shock cavalry that much. Oh yeah, and they also have a double-handed axe unit, which no other barbarian kingdom has. Which, actually no, the Saxons do. What am I saying? The Saxons have the Nordic Axe Warriors, which is a double-handed axe unit. However, this Burgundian axeman is better because, unlike the Nordic axe warriors, actually, if I'm correct, they do have it too. Let me just check. Oh yeah, they do have it. They have immune to fear and scare everyone. What they don't have is the, they don't have the same mass. They are slightly worse, like when it comes to armor, but the Nordic Axe Warriors do have precursors, so just be careful of that. And of course, if you don't know what a precursor is basically what you call a missile for infantry. Precursors are usually like javelins. Up until Attila, it was javelins, but now it became throwing axes, javelins, plumbatas, which are darts. I think that's about it. And yeah. Oh yeah, and people tend to like not play the Huns like correctly or properly. And this is just because unlike like the Romans in Rome 2, the Huns are much harder to play as, in my opinion. Not just in my opinion, but also when you see people in multiplayer, like they struggle so much with the Huns. They try to use like meta tactics, like this guy, when I was just starting out Attila, he said, you know, the best way to win is use Ur warriors and chosen Ur warriors, and then use shock cavalry because shock cavalry are very strong in this game. And they are very strong, but I do not like overpowered units, and shock cavalry are somewhat overpowered. First wave lancers do lose to most shock cav, and most of the Hunnic cavalry are actually less than heavy. Only one unit is heavy, and that's the noble stick cataphracts, when it comes to cavalry, of course. When it comes to infantry, the heaviest they have is Bosphorian infantry. Ur warriors and chosen Ur warriors are both medium. They do, however, wield the Kanda, and that's what I wanted to talk about. The last thing, of course. The Kanda is basically different from, let's just say, the heavy Spatha, which is another weapon that, oops, not that faction. The East Romans don't have it. The Western Romans have it. The heavy Spatha, or Elite Spatha, I think it's called in the game files, is basically has the same weapon damage. Here you go. Has the same weapon damage as the Kanda. It does have more armor piercing. It has 14 armor piercing and 36 base damage. On the Kanda has 40 base damage and 10 armor piercing. The difference, however, is the hidden stats. The Kanda wield has a bonus of 10 against infantry. The heavy Spatha doesn't. What this means, in my theory, of course, like I said earlier, is that there's the chance that the a hidden bonus against infantry, like a club, or even the Kanda, or even double-handed axes, to double and single-handed axes, don't have the same debuffs that, or don't suffer the same debuffs as a whole that other units would have. For example, let's go over to these Swabians, and I've seen this happen when I've played as the Swabians too. You know, you're doing really well with Swabby champions, but once these guys get exhausted, it's just game over for them. Their melee defense is cut in half, their melee tech goes down by 40%, and so it hits the 30s, the high 30s, I think. You know, their weapon damage stays the same, their charge bonus goes down, and yeah, overall, like, their morale also hits, gets a nosedive, but they shouldn't rout. Basically, why I'm mentioning this is because the Swabby champions are a very good unit early on, but over the course of a battle, if they get exhausted, and they're going to just take hit after hit, and that's pretty much game over for them. So keep, like, killing units as quickly as possible with units like Swabby champions or Godin's men. Well, Godin's men can go berserk, so it's not a big deal with them, but with these guys, it's kind of important to do that. Of course, Swabby warriors, it's the same thing because they are axe units, but they have less melee defense. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. Expect a guide sometime this month. I am trying my best. And yeah, thanks guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, you know, just say in the chat. Just come watch me next time. I'm going to try my best to stream tomorrow. I might not though, who knows. I definitely will be working on my guide when I come off the stream and for the next few days. I might have to reword some of the stuff for some of the factions because they, like, my perspective on them has changed. For like example, the Lachmids, the White Huns, maybe even the Saxons, I don't know. I haven't really played as the Saxons in multiplayer that much anymore because I've really struggled with them. But I will hopefully be able to give you guys a really good guide on how to really become familiar with these factions and of course become better at the game. Thanks guys so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Bye guys.